This is the Schmo with the Pro, Coach Greg Jackson, here at Jackson Wink, here in New Mexico. How we doing?
Very well. How are you, sir?
Hey, the Schmo can't complain. We're catching you before you take your flight to Las Vegas. Big fight for Michelle Waterson, the Karate Hottie main event against Marina Rodriguez.
Yeah, it's going to be a real tough fight, kind of short notice thing, but we'll do our best. We really believe in Michelle. It's going to be it'll be another interesting night, I'm sure.
Two bangers that are not afraid to mix things up on their feet, but the Karate Hottie here at Jackson Wink, I could swear that the wrestling's going to be used at some extent, yeah?
Well, you never know what'll happen, right? You show up and you hope it all goes well.
Yes. Now the Schmo's here. We see a lot of killers training. Holly Holm, she's getting her first sparring in since the injury. How do you think she looked today?
She looked great. You know, she's just so mentally and physically tough. She's one of the toughest people I know. So it's always a pleasure to watch her come back from an injury, kind of get back in the swing of things, feel that flow, feel that love again. So it's been a good day.
Anticipating another crack at the Bantamweight Championship, which she held. How do you think she felt when she saw Juliana Pena, who was supposed to be her opponent, getting the crack at Amanda Nunez's belt?
Well, you know, you're always disappointed. You always want to try, you know, to be there, but life sometimes gets in the way, and she'll, like I said, she's super mentally tough, so she'll adapt, overcome, and when it's her time, it'll be her time.
Not many guys had a better year than Aaron Pico in 2020. Went 3-0. He had three finishes, too. How is Aaron Pico looking right now? I'm sure he's getting ready for his fight next month.
Yeah, he's such a killer. He's really growing, especially as a fighter. So he's got some good technical ability as well, but just learning how to stay calm, stay patient, when to attack, when to retreat, when to kind of go for the finish. These are things that are very hard to teach, and he's really starting to get it.
And listen, let's talk about the biggest fight the UFC could ever be making right now. It's Francis Ngannou against the one and only John Bones Jones, the GOAT. John Bones Jones, he's coming here. How would you say he is mentally right now? Because, look, it's about money. That's the only thing that's causing this thing to not been booked yet.
Well, you know, I think he's just focused on improving, seeing how he does at heavyweight, seeing how he feels, and I've never seen him look better. So I think the heavyweight division is in a lot of trouble once he makes that full transition, once he really feels comfortable. I think, yeah, it's a lot of people should be on notice.
He's looking yoked, and he's obviously one of the smartest guys to enter the cage. How is the speed, though, with the muscle gain?
You know, the thing about John is that it doesn't seem to affect him at all, and I don't know why, but he seems almost faster at heavyweight. Maybe it's the additional muscle propelling the speed of his movements, but yeah, he looks great.
Yes. And what's going on with you, Coach Jackson? What would you say is your biggest goal for 2021, the remainder of this year?
You know, I just want to stay in the process, still have fun with it, still make sure that all the fighters are getting the best chance they can to win and do well in their careers. And so it's just another same old year for me of pure joy, right? Like, I love my job. I'm so lucky I get to do it. So, yeah, just focusing on keeping the main thing the main thing.
I got to ask you a fun question, because GSP, George St. Pierre, he spent a lot of time here. If that dream matchup with Khabib ever went down, how do you envision that one would end?
Well, you know, I actually really like Khabib. He's an amazing guy, super nice to me. George is my guy, so obviously I would have to hope we would win, but it'd be a super exciting match. It'd be a lot of fun to see.
What would be the secret sauce for GSP to getting his hand raised, though, if that were to ever happen?
Well, it might happen, so I wouldn't say exactly, but it would be an interesting fight for sure.
Excellent. Final message for the Greg Jackson fans out there worldwide.
Thanks for being fans.
It's a good message either way.
There you go.
He's the Pro. I'm the Schmo here at Jackson Wink. We'll see you in Las Vegas.
See you there, Ruck.
We're out.
Easy, Jay. Professional.